The day an incident shook Athens, quite literally. On the 9th of August 1978, a Boeing 747-200B, operated by Olympic Airways, was flying the popular route Athens to New York and had 418 people on board, 18 of which were crew members. The plane was taking off from Athens's old airport, which is now shut down. It was called Elinkion International Airport, and it was located in the centre of Athens. The Boeing 747 had advanced technology for its time, with more efficient and quieter engines. Most airplanes have these types of engines nowadays. The Exxon airplane had a newer design of this engine called the JT9D, and it used water injection to deliver more thrust. The captain, 55-year-old Sifis Migadis, had 32 years of experience with the airline. The co-pilot was Konstantinos Kostas Vikarados, who was as equally experienced as the captain. Exact flight hours were not available. In the afternoon, the plane started its takeoff roll. Upon lifting off, the water flow alarms go off for the number 3 engine, but the crew misinterpreted this as the water run out alarm, so the crew turned off the water injection for all 4 engines. This greatly reduced thrust, leaving the plane at close to stall speeds for the rest of the flight. The pilots decide to retract the gear only 35 feet or 11 meters from the ground, as this would reduce drag, but this was not standard procedure. The plane flew only a few feet or meters from apartment buildings in Athens and ended up hitting many television antennas and nearly the Inter-American Tower. After slowly climbing to 209 feet, the airplane flew over Pani Hill, but then dropped to 180 feet whilst flying over Kalithea, Nea Cimrini and Sigaru. During this journey, the crew managed to dip the nose and gain enough speed to increase thrust of the engines. However, the plane was approaching one of the mountains surrounding Athens, called Mount Aigelio, which stood around 1,500 feet, or 475 metres. This was a problem for the crew, as the now low speed and altitude meant that they were going to crash into it. However, at 2:05 p.m, a little headwind gave the airplane altitude, and this gave both pilots a chance to turn away from the mountain and towards the sea. The crew then flew for a few minutes to dump fuel and they returned back to Elinkion International Airport safely with no injuries or deaths, both inside and outside the aircraft. What could have been a disaster was skillfully diverted by the crew. All of Boeing's simulations of the flight resulted in crashes. However, the pilots were also the ones who caused the disaster to start with, as found by the AAIASB, or the Hellenic Air Accident Investigation and Aviation Safety Board, joined by Boeing. As said here from an interview, no malfunction in the airframe or engines caused a lack of performance following takeoff. Instead, the problem was caused by the inadvertent shutdown of the water injection pumps by the flight crew and the resulting decrease in thrust. Loss of wet thrust in a situation where the airplane was in its takeoff climb severely reduced the ability to continue the flight with any significant amount of positive climb gradient. Once thrust was manually increased at a coordination time of approximately 325 seconds, the airplane climbed out in a normal manner. Brian S. Weigel, Vice President of Customer Service, Boeing. thank you so much for watching my video. Please like and subscribe if you liked the video, and put your video ideas in the comments below. Thank you.